get ready to match the stars from Carter Country, Geach Cook, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, from What's Happening, Mabel King, from Flying High, Ben Olsen, and Marsha Wallace, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rather.
Well, John, already out there, thank you for joining us here on Match Game DM. You're going to be glad you did, because we have some beautiful people on this here now stage. I greet you, and thank you for joining us. Good evening to you. Now, would you join me in greeting Diane McCain and Bob Henry?
Yes.
I'd like to find out a little bit about each of you before we begin. Bob, we'll begin with you. You can tell us anything you like about old Bob Henry. He's a good old boy, right?
He is. I live in La Jolla.
Time's up. Thank you very much, Bob. Oh, you live in La Jolla?
I live in La Jolla.
It's a beautiful place.
Little southern town in California.
Right.
I have five children. They're all graduated from college and are happily married. And this year, my wife and I took our savings, bought a boat, started Mexico, went up to Alaska, and we're on our way back now, and had a wonderful time.
Well, congratulations to you for doing something different like that. Isn't that marvelous? Okay. Good luck to Bob Henry. Now, this young lady, Diane, tell us about you.
Well, I'm a native Californian, which is a rarity. I'm single. I live in Van Nuys.
That's one offer.
Okay. Keep that in mind. I'm an accountant for a real estate company. I'm a season ticket holder for the Dodgers and the Kings. Big sports fan. And I have two kittens at home who watch the show, if you can believe that one.
Wonderful. Cats love us, don't they?
Yes.
Okay, good luck to both of you. Now, here on Match Game PM, you'll each have three opportunities to match as many of our stars as you possibly can. The one who does that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner, and that person will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $20,000. Oh, boy, good luck. Here we go. Bob Henry, A or B?
B, please.
B for Bob, he says. Jim said, I just saw a very strange movie that takes place in a delicatessen. It's a love story about a bagel that falls in love with a blank. Love story about a bagel that falls in love with a blank. Here we go, Bob. Jim said, I just saw a very strange movie that takes place in a delicatessen. It's a love story about a bagel that falls in love with a blank.
Lox.
A lox. Well, they go together. Bagel that fell in love with some lox there. What do you say, Geach?
I thought there was something fishy about that answer, but I said
You said lox, too. All right. Are other possibilities in round one questions?
Well, I went for the big time. I said salami.
Wonderful. That's one of the other good possibilities. I love you in basic black, my
Thank
dear.
You.
You look smashing.
Don't Dracula thinks so, too.
Why do I
matzo ball?
Matzo ball? You said a bagel that falls in love with a matzo ball.
That has a nice ring to it, like a Woody Allen type.
That's right. No, that is a Woody Allen style thing. All right. It's a love story about a bagel that falls in love with a...
With cream cheese yet.
Lox with cream cheese. Okay, Mabel. What do you say to this, Ken Olson?
Yeah, well, that's a medley from my hometown of Dorchester. We used to have it every Sunday night. Lox!
All right. You're doing okay, Bob. You got three so far. Let's see if you capture Marcia.
Oh, yeah. Well, you may. It says it's a recurring dream. Sausage.
Yes, of course. That's a wonderful answer.
Bagels and sausages.
Right. All right. Diane, you ready for yours?
Yeah.
Here it is. Tom said, my car is really old. A little slow, but will improve as time goes on. My car is really old. In fact, the owner's manual is written in blank. The owner's manual is written in blank.
I just want him to put his card in the slot.
Here we go. Tom said, my car is really old. In fact, the owner's manual is written in blank.
Sanskrit.
Sanskrit. Okay, Diane. Y'all know about that in East Texas, right?
We don't hardly write in the sand at all. We find it doesn't make for lasting novels, but I tell you what does is stone. If you write
written
it in stone.
It was
an old car.
It was written in stone, right. Carved in stone there. What do you say to this?
I say there are a lot of good writers coming out of Texas in the last 10 years, and I said Sanscripto.
Sanscripto, there's one.
You took my phone.
Hello there. Chuck, you ready for yours?
Let Mabel do the numbers. Sanscript.
Okay, there it is. Charles doesn't want Brett to do the numbers. He wants you to do them instead, Mabel.
I'll sing for you, darling.
Right. Okay.
It was written in script, as in Sanscript.
What is the matter? What's the matter? What's wrong, darling?
You got the buzz. Script.
Sanskrit?
It's not Sanskrit, yeah. Okay.
Ah.
Yeah, just checking with you. Oh.
That's how they are, honey.
That's how they are. It's a hard world.
She won't do the vocal.
Kitten, are you a flabbergasted?
Flabbergasted? Yes.
Let's see your flabbergasted expression.
Ding, 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 Sanskrit.
There it is. All right. 3-3 score. Hello, darling.
Hello, my dear. Given my fiery Italian nature, I said Latin.
Latino. Now, that's another good possibility.
Yeah.
Latin, Sanskrit, any of the ancient tongues is okay. So, end of round one, we got a tie score. 3-3. Round two coming up right after this. Now, here we have a tie score here. We'll go to round two. And since the score is tied and he went first last time, we thought you might want to go first this time.
Okay, I'll take A, please.
You want A. All right. Here's a match game riddle for you. How do you tell Zsa Zsa Gabor's age?
You
the answer,
don't.
You count her blanks.
Cruel people.
Only three people play. You are not one.
Unfortunately,
you play,
I'm one of
Mabel,
them.
You play. And Geech plays.
Geech.
All right, Diane. A match game riddle. How do you tell Zsa Zsa Gabor's age? The answer, you count her blanks.
Two good answers, but I'll take diamonds.
Diamonds?
Diamonds.
What was your other answer?
Husbands.
Husbands was your other answer?
Husbands.
I think you blew it, Diane.
Yeah, I know. I think you did.
Hello, Geech.
I thought husbands times seven.
Husbands times seven. That's one way of doing it. Okay, Diane. Let's see what Mabel has.
Darling, always go for the man. Yeah. Husbands.
Husbands. Marcia,
I love my answer.
You love your answer.
You know, I'm not playing in a vacuum, and it's wrong, but I love it anyway. Count her rings, like rings around a tree.
Aha! Very good. Has a double meaning. Excellent. All right. Bobby, you ready for yours?
Ready.
Here's what it says. After Dave built his hot air balloon, he needed lots of hot air to fill it up, so he took it to blank. You don't play? You don't. Geech, you don't play. Here it is.
Oh, I like it. What's that woman's name who does the speed reading?
Evelyn Woods.
If we could just get Charles into Evelyn Woods, it would be so helpful.
Bob, after Dave built his hot air balloon, he needed lots of hot air to fill it up. So he took it to blank.
I'm really stuck for an answer about that. Gabby.
Gabby. Any Gabby person.
Any Gabby.
There's one really excellent answer to this, Bob, which you will hear
Gabby.
In a moment or so from Brett Summers.
Brett Summers, isn't she lovely?
She's lovely.
I said Washington.
Yeah. Yeah. Has ever had lots of hot air, Bob? Yeah. That's right. What'd you say?
No,
matzo ball. That was the previous question.
Congress.
Another good answer. And you, my dear, what do you have to offer for old Bob Henry?
It eluded me.
It did?
So I went to my old standby, Howard Cosell.
Oh, of course.
Now, there's
a lot of logic to that. When in doubt, you just write Howard Cosell.
For anything. All right.
Okay, the score is still tied. Diane went first last time, so Bob, we'll ask you to go first this time.
A, please.
A it is. Let's see what we have now. Brett, Charles, and Marsha. Dumb Donald is really dumb. B minus. He thought the Super Bowl was a giant blank. That's how dumb Donald was. Dumb Donald really dumb. He thought the Super Bowl was a giant blank. Okay. Bob Henry is chuckling at his answer, and he hasn't even said it yet. Bob, Dumb Donald is really dumb. Dumb Donald is really dumb. He thought the Super Bowl was a giant blank.
Potty.
Potty or toilet? Okay. They're a bunch of weirdos. You're cheering toilets. Hello there, Brett.
He thought the Super Bowl was a giant toilet bowl.
Toilet.
Oh,
yeah, right. They think about it, too.
I said toilet also.
Okay.
We're up to five. We need one more.
One more toity.
That's right.
Got it.
Okay. Now, Diane, the best you can do is achieve a tie. Well, you can do that by matching all three celebrities you haven't matched so far. Harry said, I am never going back to that rotten doctor. He gave me some pills that were supposed to shrink my sinuses, but instead they shrank my blank.
I think the audience is here. That's
yeah.
Who writes the questions?
Oh, faster than a speeding bullet. Faster than a speeding bullet.
Did you ever get to thinking you're too smart for the room?
What is it? What? What is he doing there? What,
Charles, what are you doing?
He does it right.
Oh, I'm good as inside, yes. Yeah. It's all coming back.
Now you remember how it goes.
Are we on?
Okay, here we go. Harry said, I'm never going back to that rotten doctor. He gave me some pills that were supposed to shrink my sinuses, but instead they shrank my blank.
Brain.
Brain. Okay, you need three brains here. Show us your brain, Geach.
I thought seat of all learning.
Oh, dear, no. No, Max, I mean, Bob Harry wins the game. Who do you have? Nose and Ken Tornado and okay. Diane, we thank you very much for being here on Match Game PM to show our appreciation. We're going to send some gifts your way. Diane McCain, ladies and gentlemen, my spinner off and spin a commercial for you. When you come back and see how much money Bob Henry wins. Here we go with Bob Henry.
I couldn't help it. We have plenty of time.
It's time now for the Big Money Super Match, Bob, where you can win over $20,000. And to do that, we have two audience matches for you. And if you're ready for it, we'll go with the first one. We polled a studio audience in this very room, a very high IQ bunch like these. And we said, write down your best answer to this. I wish I was blank. Now, if you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, we give you $500. For matching their second most popular answer, $250. And then if you match a third, $100. Nothing to it. Now, you can get some help from three of our six stars.
Brett.
I wish I was in Dixie. Away.
I wish I was in Dixie.
Charles.
I wish I...
Hey, now, Brett, you leave him alone. Go ahead, Charles, do your act. Or whatever. Hello, Charles. Charles.
I wish I was a sunbeam.
I wish I was a sunbeam. You will always be a sunbeam in my eyes, Charles. One more.
Mabel.
Mabel, have you got one?
I wish I was dead.
Oh, all right. We should be glad to oblige. Bang! You dead.
I'm dead.
Okay. There they are, Bob. You got, I wish I was dead. I wish I was a sunbeam. And I wish I was in Dixie. Hooray, hooray. And I'm da 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 da. Cut. Thank you very much for your kind attention there. You want one of those?
Well, let's see. Yes.
What do you want to do, Bob?
I wish I was in Dixie.
Dixie. Okay, that's another one. Let's go down to the bottom and reveal the $100 number. I wish I was dead is Mabel's answer. That came up there.
That's
Don't cry, Mabel.
Talk. Must have been a fun group that day.
We want Dixie is what we're after. May we see the next one, please? I wish I was rich. That's a pipe dream.
I wish I was rich, too.
Yeah, don't we all? Our last chance for Dixie. Slide the big one. Yeah! Yeah, boy. Okay. Now, Bob, you've won the $500, which means the least we'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But you got another audience match, and we'll see how much more you'll win with that one. All right, may we see it, please? Leaping blank.
Oh.
You can call on three again.
I'd like to stay with Mabel.
You want to stay with Mabel?
Lizards.
Leaping lizards.
Brett.
Oh, leaping. There's leaping lizards. Leaping frog.
Leaping frog. Okay.
Charles.
Sunbeam.
I really.
Leaping sunbeam.
A leaping sunbeam. I really don't like a show that hasn't got a sunbeam. Anyway, in honor of my friend named Horn, Leaping Lena.
Leaping Lena. Okay. Leaping Lena, Leaping Lizards, and Leaping Frogs. You can choose one of those again or give us one of your own, Bob.
No. Leaping, I like the lizards.
You like lizards?
Is he right?
Okay, we'll find out if he's right and if you're right. We'll begin at the bottom. You're going to be sorry. You talked him into lizards, you know. If he blows the money, it's your fault. And we're going to walk among you and take up a collection. All right, let's slide the $100 number. Leaping oh! Lena.
It's there.
It's there. Wonderful.
Sorry. Believe it.
How wonderful.
Charles.
It is. I hope Patty Jukes saw that. That
no, it's
that's acting.
Just a bit overdone, if I may
bad
say so, Charles. There. Bring it down just a mite, if you would, please. May we see the next one? Leaping frogs. Okay. That was Brett's answer. All right, we want lizards. Lizards is what we're after. Go with a big one for $500. Now, you've won another $500. We multiply that by 10, which means another $5,000 added to the previous $5,000 you won. The least you'll play for is $10,000. However, you can double your money and play for $20,000 right now if you have a lucky spin of the star wheel. If the blue light stays on when the wheel stops, you will have doubled your money. Give a go. Good luck, Bob Henry. Let's hope you get the double. All right. Now, Ken Olson. I don't want you to be nervous.
No, I'm not.
No. It's only $20,000.
$20,000.
It represents everything to this man.
An entire week.
It will be in his entire life savings and everything to him. So don't be nervous, Ken.
And you do want to ride on his boat, don't you?
Okay, face me if you would please, sir. And good luck to you. Here it is. For $20,000. Grandma Blank. Grandma Blank, and we appreciate your enthusiasm, but don't say the answer because it may be a wrong one and lead him astray and then... All finished, eh? Okay, Bob. Grandma Blank. Give us the answer that matches his.
Moses.
Yeah! Grandma Moses. Yeah, sounds reasonable to me. Let's find out now from Ken Olson if you win the $20,000 or not. Ken, it's up to you.
The pressure. Moses!
Moses! Celebrate in a moment or so while we do a little business with America. Attaboy, Bob!
terrific.
Well, we have a very happy fellow here on the stage, Bob Henry, who is shaking hands and thanking everyone, and he's happy because he has a total of $21,000 to his credit here. And I don't know, what plans do you have for that amount of money, Bob?
Well, basically, I've been unemployed all year. And it'll go for household expenses.
It will.
You bet.
Okay. Well,
my wife might have other ideas.
Okay. Well, I hope she does. And I hope you'll join us next week for Match Game PM, when we'll try to give away another big bundle of money like this, and we'll have another bunch of stars as we have here tonight on Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn, goodbye.